It requires faith that's invisible. Here it is at verse number 35. Now let me give you some help in here. By the time we get from verses number 24 down to verses number 35, a woman who Josephus, a great Christian scholar, said that this woman's name was Veronica, who had an issue of blood. She wasn't scheduled, she wasn't on the agenda, but she went and touched his hem while he was on his way to Jairus' house. Y'all ain't never been here. And sometimes you just have to say, God, I need you to do something extraordinary. I know it ain't on your agenda. I know this ain't on the program. I know this ain't part of proper protocol. But I'm sick and tired of going through what I'm going through. And if don't nobody else invite me to the church, I'm going to try to get to Jesus myself. And the problem that she ran into was that it was too many traps for in the way for her to get here. Y'all ain't never been here. I know it's first Sunday, and I know the deacons and the deaconess sit close to the front. But see, I ain't got time for none of them. Maybe they like together. I need to get to the Lord for my own self. Y'all ain't helping me here. And if anybody get mad, it's the devil. Y'all ain't helping me here. I know I made my 4 or 5 y'all upset. But that's the problem here. Too many of us are in the way of other folks getting healed and blessed because we're too many trying to drink Haterade. But there needs to be some people that will pray the lame, pray the deaf, pray the blind, the trap. And so here it is, I got to hear it out of it. He says, now in verse 35, the Bible says, while he yet spake, it turned from lying at the point of death, now the situation got worse. But here it is, the text says that the people that were at the house said, you don't need to trouble the master anymore. And see, this is, Lord, help me with this, that I don't get out of my flesh and get an attitude. This is the problem that I have when you got too many folks in your life. The people have not recognized what he had already instructed God to do in prayer. He had already asked Jesus to come, lay hands, and heal, that she might live. Verse 24 says, he's on the way. But the people who have no connection to him, God, I wish I had some help in here, that have no business in your life or have the audacity to speak into your life, is the main people that you're talking to. You're talking to the wrong. Individuals knew that Jesus was on the way, they would have never said that he'd see one day. Y'all ain't helping me here. But the Bible says, I wish I had some Holy Ghost helping here, that they said that she was dead. But watch what Jesus said. He said, now, you got a choice. Now, you can listen to them, or you can listen to Jesus. Now, I come to tell you about your friends today, and this ain't on my note, I'm giving it to you free. If your friends, when you can pray about a situation, telling you it ain't gonna happen, you need to tell them, well, I thank God for you, for knowing you for as long as I have known you. But I'm hitting up the delete button right now, because see, I don't need you in my life right now. I don't need folks who tell me what my God can't do. I need some people who are telling me my God will supply. So what type of witness is here? So here it is, here it is. Y'all sit down, you make me nervous. Sit down. So here it is now. Now the text says that as soon as Jesus heard it, instead of dealing with the nonsense, Jesus looked to him and said, look, bro, all you got to do is believe. Okay, somebody in here don't believe. Look at the Bible, verse number 36. Jesus said, as soon as he heard the word that was spoken, he said unto the ruler, be not afraid, only believe. That clause only believe simply means that he had to have faith in the Lord. What he was saying was going to happen even when you don't see that it's possible. And that's what I came to tell someone today, no matter what, you just need to believe. I know it looks hard. I know it looks rough, but you got to believe God is going to do what needs to be done. And I don't know what you're going through, what you're facing right now, but I believe that God is going to hear and answer your cry. And if you know the Lord like I know him, then you will understand. Yes, sir, I feel my help already. Yes, Lord. And you will understand that we serve the kind of God that will do anything but fail. Have I got a witness in here? So you may have a dead situation going on, but some things are dead, cannot become alive when they die. Have I got a witness in here? That relationship that you're in right now, it needs to die, in order for you to live. Come on, brother, witness in here. That job that you own, that shit that don't have any benefits, you need to let it die so God can let you live. Have I got a witness in here? Yes. I hear the Bible saying, he said your daughter is not right at the point of death. But the naysayer says she's already dead because they can't believe that something dead can come back to life again. But when you leave it in Jesus' hands, the Bible said, he told the Jairus, don't listen to other folks. All you need to do is believe that God is shown available to see you through. Won't you nudge your neighbor and tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, I believe that everything is going to be alright. Yes, the Bible says that Jesus put everybody else out. Because when you're dealing with God, you don't need a whole lot of folks. Some people you need to eliminate. You need to eliminate the liars, eliminate the gossipers, the backbiters, the ditch diggers, and maybe your life will be blessed. But Jesus said, Ed, go get the mama and go get the daddy. Because one thing about God, after you give him worship, that's credible. Pray, that's desirable. Then you can expect the impossible. That's what the Bible said. That he went in the room, grabbed her by the hand, and told her to life thy kuma, which simply means a damsel get up. And that's what I came to tell somebody today. Get up out of your storm. The storm is over now. Get up out of your bed. Your bed of affliction. Yeah.